just woken up from a nap and I think he hates me right now. But I love him.
I think in many ways this is a very hard video for me to make. It's something that I've expressed in multiple ways and other forms of media throughout my life, but I've never made a video on it. It's one of those topics that just gets lost in the ether. We're not sugarcoating this here. This video is basically, why does Nicole still play dress up? It's always been a bit more than that for me. I'm a very creative person, is what it comes down to. Which has not always been easy for me to express physically up until these last few years. It has a really strong root in my childhood. The house that I grew up in was owned by my grandparents. It had been converted from a Victorian factory into a family home in the early 20th century. My grandmother, she's a seamstress. She had her business based out of the basement in this Victorian mansion, essentially. I grew up down there. I grew up playing on the clothing racks, in the clothing racks, just throwing every sort of fabric over my head that you could find. And my grandmother made me the most beautiful Halloween costumes every year from the minute I was born, literally. I was every Disney princess in the book. Every year, my ideas became more and more elaborate. I just wanted to dress as a goddess all the time. Can you blame me? I remember I actually set up like a small stage in the basement of my parents' house after we moved to the suburbs. And I had a really cheap selection of wigs even back then. And I would just set up the camera and put on skits with my brother and film them and change face. I went to university in New Jersey, became part of a very creative theater troupe who were awesome. I met one of my best friends there, Serenia.
Want to let you know that Serenia just said that she has not slept in days, but she has a steady hand.
And I'm using a jigsaw!
And we just really encouraged each other to go for it. And that's when the crazy Halloween costumes started. The really elaborate ones, because I had somebody helping me make them. 2009, dressed up as Michael Jackson, and then a year later, Lady Gaga. In 2011, I moved to Glasgow, and I really took it to the next level. Not the first year, though. I was very shy the first year I moved here, but when I did, I went nuts. I was changing my face, changing my hair, changing my clothes, experimenting, doing the things that I never did as a teenager out in the open. It was a period of time, and for quite a long time, where I thought maybe I used makeup to hide, but actually it was my truest form of self to be able to change the way I looked. That's me. That's me being healthy. I realized that I'd spent the first 25 years or so or more of my life letting others suggest how I present myself, and this bled over into everything from my career choices to my relationships. So if you're wondering why I dye my hair crazy colors now, it's because 2 years ago I had a very good counselor who finally gave me the permission I needed to hear to go ahead and be myself. Personality is such a weird thing. You know, it's something you're gonna be working on your entire life. You'll still be struggling with it when you're 55. I've been really enjoying getting to know myself again. Halloween means something even more to me now than it did as an American in America. The ancient Celtic word for Halloween is Samhain, and it's celebrated from sunset on October 31st to sunset on November 1st. The veil between this world and the next is thinnest, and that's why you get all your ghosts and ghouls coming through and all that. It's essentially the Celtic New Year, because that's when the last harvest was. And in the eyes of the ancient peoples, when your harvest was done, your year was done. It was a really great time for the ancient peoples to reflect on what worked and what didn't work in this last year that they had, and what they could do better in the next year. It was all very connected to the land and spirit and just all those wonderful basic concepts that I think sometimes we just forget. That's why I really love Halloween now. And me being able to bring that part of myself that is creative into it and really just run with it is just, there's probably a little bit of vanity involved, but if you, I don't know, if you don't like yourself for what you're doing, that's what I believe. So, to celebrate Halloween and kind of pay homage to my journey, and what changing face means to me, I've decided to put together this video and recreate all of the costumes that I have made in the last 6 years since I've moved to Glasgow. And all I ask is that you enjoy watching it just as much as I've enjoyed putting it all together. And boy, did this take ages. And without further ado, roll it.
Thank you. Shall we begin?